Hey there, long time no see. So, we're a bit late to the party on this one, but fortunately, the most exciting thing about the new BeamNG update remains largely unexplored here in YouTube land. For the patch footnotes and major new features, you've already had some wonderful videos by the BeamNG titans like Muya. In this video, however, we're going to focus on what the sim racers care about, the massive force feedback overhaul. Forget about crashes, fridges, cannonballs and all that quote-unquote fun stuff, how much closer is BeamNG to a proper sim? Very quickly, I'm going to list off a bunch of the new additions added to version 0.24 before we get to testing the force feedback. The BeamNG crew have been incredibly industrious and have now added an overview map, literally a view that will unzoom from your car and show you a top-down vision of the entire map that you're on. This shows all the new missions and events you can drive to and partake in. Oh, by the way, you can now start missions and events from the free roam. Undoubtedly inspired by titles such as GTA and Forza, it's a great gameplay mechanic to tie the various disparate aspects of BeamNG together. They've added PBR terrain materials to Utah, Jungle Rock Island, and Small Island, completely transforming how those maps come across during different times of day and also increasing the perceived details substantially. The texture pass improves just about everything and brings BeamNG into the current generation. The map overview mode, as mentioned above, comes with a new mission system, from drag races on the west coast through to precision parking in Italy. Meanwhile, the Bishu Pasima and Gavril H-series have both been remastered. They now have far more realistic details, especially on the interiors. Finally, there's been a slew of fixes and improvements, which leads us to the one that we're going to focus on in this video, the force feedback. BeamNG claim that they have made the force feedback smoother and able to translate more details, which in theory is wonderful. BeamNG has always had a wildly noisy force feedback that really needed a ton of filtering to get anything usable from. Luckily, the BeamNG crew were nice enough to get me into the beta testing phase for the new update so I could offer some quick feedback on the system. This will actually be my first time driving 0.24 after said feedback, so let's see how well they've managed to implement it while also testing some of the new content. Before we jump into that, let's first jump to that subscribe button so we can get more BeamNG news, as presented by a stuffy sim racing elitist. Aloha, welcome back to BeamNG version 0.24, or the winter update as the devs call it. Now, I've been very lucky to get a sneak peek of this as they were developing it. They were devving the force feedback system, and I got to input some nice feedback into the force feedback, as it were. Look at those tires, look at them flexing. Oh man, I love this sim. Anyway, what we're here to test out primarily is the force feedback. You have all the quality content creator channels such as Muya, who have actually done a good feature update for you and presented it in a very entertaining and well-composed way. Now you have the sim racing take, where a guy just yells at you while driving quite poorly down dirt roads. So I look forward to that. I hope you do too. We're here on Small Island to check out its new PBR texture update, as well as the massive lumbering hunk of metal you see in front of you there, also known as the Gavril H-series. That's been remastered for this update, so we're trying to knock out three birds with one stone here, so let's go. Now, I know how much you folks abhor the hood view in this title, so here we are. We're doing large bus view from the exterior as we look at this quite remarkable Small Island redo. You can really appreciate the new texture blending on the road there. Let me see if I can just get us closer to that. So that's the first thing that I noticed when they had me test this. Nobody actually told me they'd updated this with PBR textures. So the first thing I noticed, I'm like, is this a placebo? Does the game just look better to me because I haven't driven it in months, or is this something else? Turns out it's a PBR texture update for Small Island. Looks really nice. The foliage to me looks more dense as well. I feel like the draw distance is a lot further. There's a lot less noticeable pop-in, at least from what I can tell. Certainly just all looks a lot more fluid, and they probably did have to do that in order to transition this up to map view, where you get to see the entire island in one shot. So, back to bus view. I'm actually very impressed by this H-series. I don't normally drive things this large, because they're usually not very fun, but this car's kind of spirited. It's got some juice. Now, the force feedback. It's weighty once you get it to like 45 degrees and up. Still a little bit dead in the center. It just doesn't quite feel like any car I've ever owned in that regard, you know? Also, you may notice that I'm driving without a H-pattern shifter, which is a bit problematic. You're trying to heel and toe while shifting with our flappy paddles. Not quite the most intuitive motion in the world. But that's what I get for getting overzealous and selling all my stuff to move overseas a little bit earlier than I should have. Now, before I get that shifter, I am just gonna try and get used to this. take this car up as high as I can. I will say this, the force feedback, it's smoother. I'm running a far lower smoothing setting in the sim, about 220 strength, 50 smoothing, one interpolation on the bass. There's a lot less of that weird noise coming from the tires. I'm feeling a bit more of the road surface distinguished from that noise. I won't say it's a revolution, it's more of an evolution. The center is still quite dead comparatively. It just doesn't have, I don't know, lacks a certain weightiness to it. It lacks that race room factor, whereas race room everything is super heavy feeling. And kind of rubber bandy in a way that feels convincing to me. Woo! Damn, son! Wow! Wow, what a car! I am climbing the highest hill that I can find, ladies and gents, because it's time to conclude Small Island and the Gavril, and time to move on to greener pastures, such as the Nürburgring, because of course, all roads lead to the Nürburgring, especially this one. Oh, man. The crashes look lovely in PBR, don't they? PBR car, PBR smoke, I assume. Please don't explode. Yes, so we're going to test the Bischu Pacima at the one and only Nürburgring Nordschleife. I'm very curious to see how the force feedback might have developed once a car with some actual downforce hits the track. Let's do that. All right, we're of course doing the touring car variant of the Bischu the new car. We're testing out the new car's force feedback. Now, unfortunately for me, it's front-wheel drive. I absolutely abhor front-wheel drive, but it'll be a great force feedback test because, as you probably know from driving your mum's Civic, front-wheel drive cars feel a certain way through the steering column when you accelerate, namely atrocious. And I'm going to see how closely they got that atrocious feeling down here in Beam and G. So, let's do it. Again, I have to drive using the flappy paddles and the... Wait. Oh no, we have a sequential. I'm pretty happy with that. Alright, steering feel is a lot... it's a lot lighter? Whoa! Alright, not as much aero. I mean, it's a touring car, it's not really a GT3. Still a lot easier through here than iRacing is, that's for sure. Very forgiving. It's one thing I will give Beam and G, it's gone from uber unforgiving driving to extremely forgiving driving. Which is very impressive given its damage model, isn't it? It just loves climbing on those curbs, it's not a problem at all. Okay, so I mean, so far it's a pretty straightforward car, a little floppy on the straights there. The sensation of downforce, assuming this car actually creates any, isn't quite as pronounced as I would expect. That's one thing the Beam is kind of like, okay, there's a bit more damping at high speed, okay, it's getting better. I wouldn't call it world class. Still feeling a little bit of, I don't know, like weird noise and grain through here. I don't know, it's like 70 to 80% there, the Beam and G force feedback. It gives you everything that you need to drive just fine. I can drive this thing. Doesn't have ABS, ladies and gents. The things that you find out on your first time drive. But you know, it's the trip down the Nürburgring. How can that ever be a bad thing? It does need to be dialed up for this lovely front-wheel drive car. I think one thing I would like to see from the title is the devs evening out the strengths of the force feedback between the cars. I'm not sure if they're making an account for the fact that some are power steering cars, others aren't hydraulically assisted at all, some are electronic steering. Of course, they're going to make a vast difference to the way certain things come across, but this feels a little bit limp right now. Definitely needs to be turned up a bit, especially compared to the H-Series. Conversely, if I... Powered by Bischu Oilex. Sure. I mean, what would motor racing be without fossil fuel companies? I suppose we'll find out over the next 5 years. A little scary here heading towards the end of Sector 2. I don't really know how much slowing down is going to require here. I'm going to assume more than I'm going to give it. Oh my god, it lacks downforce. Alright, Sector 3, my favorite part of any track in all of motorsport. Let's see how well Beam and G conveys that sensation. Still quite limp, but oh my... No! Fairly limp in the sensor there, but that's pretty common of front-wheel drive vehicles, you know? Oh no! I definitely did something. Right, here we have a slightly lower-end version of the same car that you can't see from this fuel pump. Yes, look at that gorgeous PBR shaded interior with way too much zoom. So, let's get this going. I'm curious how it differs from the spec'd out race version. Okay, a lot of burning up. I feel like it's very limp on the force feedback here. You know what, it quite literally reminds me of the Toyota Yaris my mum used to own. It's like all the joy of motorsport being sucked out of your soul through your hands. It's very impressive in that regard. They've really conveyed that sensation of like low-end front-wheel drive cars. Very, very vague around the center. Now, that is true to all the road-going front-wheel drive cars I've ever driven. So it might just be a matter of needing to, you know, equate for the force feedback strengths between vehicles, because some are very, very strong under the same... Woo, that torque steer, it's a thing. Okay, I think that's about all the tests that we need here in front-wheel drive land. Finally, we're here in the ever-popular Utah. This has probably been the biggest undertaking in terms of their PBR shader update, assuming they haven't done the West Coast quite yet. Now, let's have at it. Okay. So I wanted to actually have some fun with the vehicle and drive one of my absolute favorites, the Gavril Barsto Track Sport. As you know, this is one of my absolute favorites in the game. I'm still trying to work out how to drive it with a combination of clutch and heel and toe and flappy paddles. It's very uncanny. Oh yeah. Okay, the self-aligning forces are very good. That's what these old rear-wheel drive cars are really good tests of. It still seems like I can get the car turning in, like, strangely. It seems it's a little too prone to trail braking, almost in that iRacing way, but kind of worse. As long as you're, like, you're keeping a bit of your foot on the brake, you can really just turn the car in no matter what speed you're going. You know, it just seems a little tiny bit disconnected. If we get picky with it, that's all. The force feedback on this car, the damping has probably been the best out of the lot. It just feels more connected, but because the force feedback is stronger on this car, man, I'm going fast. I really hope I can slow down. What? I clutched. Why are you griefing me? Beam and G, well, let's go back down. Oh, look at that. There's that PBR experience right there. Sun just blinding you off the tarmac. Happens a lot in real life, doesn't it? It's almost one of the effects you don't want them to- Oh no! Well, it's still Beam and G, that's for sure. Now we're gonna test it out at nighttime. I don't think I've ever driven at nighttime in Beam and G in my life, but... Wow. Alright. That is kinda cool. That is like some of the most realistic I've ever seen Beam and G look. I guess the PBR really helps with that. The way the environment interacts with light. So I've got the high beams on. I feel like they're a little weak, but maybe they're just weak because, you know, that's what this car is. You know what? It actually looks really good at nighttime. I always assume the Beam and G would just kind of suck at this time of day. But that's actually pretty good. That is really awesome. That's really, really awesome. Gives you that lonely country drive feeling. Except with a lot more wind noise. Now, are we entering a tunnel? This looks like it might hurt. Oh, wow. Oh, cool. The loading changes. It's fine. Just get off the wall. Ooh, okay. Nah, she's fine. That is a really cool lighting change. I'm actually very impressed by this. I've never tested out Beam and G in the nighttime before. It's a great switch. It's kind of what you would expect to happen in real life. And we'll see how it switches back once I leave the tunnel, assuming my completely not damaged car manages to pull through. This is a large mountain, isn't it? Wow. Okay. It's a shame you don't really get that, you know, that really nice sound that you normally get in tunnels in real life. Okay. Well, that's a sound. It never ceases to really, really impress me. Oh, wow. That is impressive. I don't even know if I have any lights. Oh, I got lights left. I got like a light left. Wow. Well, that is Beam and G 0.24, at least the tiny, tiny fraction of it that I've shown you here, mostly centered around the force feedback and a couple of the tracks. Oh, that looks really nice. It's always in development. They're always adding things. So For those of us who bought it for a pittance years and years and years ago, the amount of value that you get out of this title is absolutely tremendous, and I can't wait to see what the next update is. And I'm also keen to see if they can refine that force feedback just that little bit more and get us some of that wheel damping force I keep talking about. So until then, make sure to dig in, enjoy the new mission system, try it all out. There's hidden things all over the place. They've like tweaked little ins and outs everywhere that's not even listed on most of the notes. So get in. It's like an early Christmas present. So yeah, dive in, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one. Make sure to subscribe for more vacuous Beam and G content.